who lives in Northern Virginia, and how has it changed from what it was 10 years ago and just 4 years ago even?
In many ways, you can think of Virginia as a America writ small. We have our liberal Northeast in Northern Virginia. We have our high-tech corridor in Dulles. We have our industrial heartland in Hampton Roads. We have in Virginia Beach, our Sun Coast. We have our deep, deep conservative rural areas across the center of the state. We have mountains where there's vacations and retirees in many parts of the state. So in many ways, Virginia looks like America. And as a result, a 50-50 country is also a 50-50 state. When you think about Northern Virginia, it's important to remember that there are basically two different slices of Northern Virginia. There's an inner suburb, Arlington, Alexandria, most of Fairfax County, that's going to be quite Democratic. Beyond the distant suburbs, into more rural areas of the state, that's going to be quite Republican. And so the real battle for Virginia is the battle over the outer suburbs, you know, the more western and southern reaches of Fairfax County, as well as neighboring counties like Prince William and Loudoun, where you're seeing a lot of people who have come into these counties for the jobs. Campaigns in Virginia are won and lost on the basis of ground games. They're really won and lost on the basis of, do you get to the people who are going to vote for you? And do you get them to the polls once you've connected with them? For Republican voters, that means connecting very closely with evangelical churches. It means connecting very closely with more rural areas of the state, making sure that there's a really high level of turnout.
How would you describe sort of the demographics of these people?
What you're looking at in Northern Virginia in terms of the people coming here is a very diverse population. You have a large number of Latino voters in Northern Virginia. You have a large number of African American voters in Northern Virginia. And you have a growing number of other immigrant groups as well, particularly Asians are very hot, fought after in Virginia politics. So you have younger people, people who are cross-pressured. They might work for the government, they might work for the military, they might be defense contractors, but they're not Christian conservative voters necessarily. They may be conservative in terms of fiscal matters, but a lot of them tend to have moderate to liberal social views. And that's why we're talking about such cross-pressured voters in Northern Virginia. Neither party is sufficiently economically conservative to appeal to the moderate voters, nor is it sufficiently liberal on social issues to appeal to those same moderate voters. This is why the Republicans and the Democrats are fighting to a draw in many parts of this country, because neither party offers up the complete package that voters say they want. The trends that you see in Northern Virginia have been going on really for 10 years. The question is, where is that line between the inner suburbs that vote Democratic and the outer suburbs that are more Republican or more swing voters? And over the last 10 years, we've seen that line sort of move further and further west and south from D.C. And when you look at some of these new developments, you're looking at a lot of people who aren't connected to Virginia historically. They don't have a real connection to the more conservative Republican message that Virginians in Richmond offer. And that's a real problem. If you were to look at, you know, one of the key factors in Virginia politics, I think, in this election cycle, is the Republican brand. The Republican brand has been, I think, damaged by the actions of the state legislature. And this is an issue in particular for women voters. If you look at the last legislative session, the Republicans control both the House and the Senate, although it's 2020, the Republican lieutenant governor breaks the tie in the Virginia Senate. The Republican governor of the state, Bob McDonnell, specifically asked the Republican majorities not to overreach, not to go too far in a conservative, socially conservative direction. And that's exactly what the Republican lawmakers did in Richmond. They proposed and passed legislation that talked about vaginal internal ultrasounds for pregnant women that would be required. Ultimately, they backed down from that position. But ultimately, Virginia became a national laughingstock. It was a subject for conversation on the Colbert Report. And that's a real problem for moderate swing voters when the state government moves in a really conservative direction.